So speak to the geeks on the road again. I'm at Solar and Storage Live at the NEC in Birmingham. And this is a bit of a weird visit for me, because normally I come to these events and I'm doing research for myself. But today I'm kind of here for fun, just to see what's going on. So I'm still at my car. I've got to walk all the way there now. So I will see you inside. So I thought I'd start at the CATL stand, because they make the batteries for pretty much everything really, and they've got a really nice new way of tracking the life cycle of a battery. So they give each battery a unique ID, and that ID sticks with it for its whole lifespan, and you can trace where the raw materials came from, all the information about the cells, even things like the warranty on them. So they're really trying to push their green credentials at the moment. So there's a lot of ethical and green effort going into the tracing of batteries right now. Give Energy are here. I think they're the title sponsor or the headline sponsor or something, and they've got two quite large stands. They've got some talks going on. I think they've got a demonstration. I saw Emily Romaine from EcoBubble earlier giving a bit of a talk on the stand. I don't think there's any point me going into the product lines there, because I've gone over them a lot in my videos, but they've got all the usual suspects on show. They've got EV charger, they've got the all-in-one and gateway. They've got the hybrid inverters on show as well, so they've got the full range of products there. I've even got the three-phase stuff available to show off too. So I don't have much experience of three-phase, but it's certainly quite an interesting area for them to move into, as we need more and more power in our homes. So it might be domestic demand, but certainly there's going to be commercial demand for that.
What do they say about YouTubers? There's never any YouTubers around, and then all of a sudden three of them come along at once. There we go. It's Tim and Kat.
How you doing?
Does anyone know what the collective noun is for YouTubers?
It's a huddle of YouTubers.
Huddle of YouTubers, yeah. Okay.
So you see the neon green glow, and it must be My Energy. Now, I'm actually going to be doing a separate video comparing My Energy and Give Energy products, because they've got quite an overlapping portfolio now. But while I'm here, I thought I'd just have a quick look and see if there's anything new on the stand. Clearly, I've already got the Eddy sitting in my house at home, and there's the Zappy, but I thought I'd get another quick look at the Libby, the battery that they're selling now.
So check this out. This is the Libby control box, I think it is. It basically links the battery, the Libby battery, into the My Energy ecosystem. And what I find amusing today is the Libby battery here on display is made of cardboard. I'm guessing the actual real one is way too heavy for them to report on site. But at least you get a good idea of the size comparison, because there's the Eddy up there and there's the Zappy just next to it. So it's not massive really, it's quite a reasonably sized battery. It's probably about the same size as the Give Energy all-in-one really.
So I thought I'd come and have a look at the Solar Edge stuff. I've got to look where I'm going, because it's really busy. It's absolutely rammed around the Solar Edge stand. The reason I wanted to look is because I've obviously got a SolarEdge inverter myself, the 3680H, and obviously I'm not after any extra storage at all, but I know they've got a huge number of products on display here, a lot of things I wasn't aware of, so let's go and have a quick look.
This is something new I didn't know about. SolarEdge are doing an EV charger. I can't find any information about it. It's got a Type 2 socket. So it might be quite a standard thing. But we've also got this backup interface. I think that's going to be like the gateway, some sort of gateway, so as you can run from battery offline. And there's obviously a hot water controller there, which is going to be like your Eddy. I've managed to find a data sheet here, so there's a bit more information about the SolarEdge EV charger. It is an AC charger there. The Home hub inverters, they are like hybrid solar inverters, so they do the battery and the solar panels. And then you've got the home backup interface, which is actually like the gateway. It's like a Tesla gateway or a Give Energy gateway.
When I was looking at the floor plan of this event before I came here, I noticed Google on there. So I've got a bit of a list of things I need to see. And Google are on that list. So I was wondering what they were here for. It's not normal for a big technology company like that to be at a solar show. Turns out they've got a solar API to give you lots of information about solar forecast predictions and that sort of thing, covering the whole of the UK. They've still not got full detail across all of the UK, but they're getting there. And I was speaking to Gary from Gary Does Solar, and he's using it as part of his solar asthma project that he's building. Or at least he's looking into using it. I don't know whether it's actually an integral part of it yet, but it certainly could be a useful component of it.
Oh man, I'll be honest, this event is massive and I'm getting quite lost. There's a lot of EV chargers, a huge amount of EV chargers, a lot of commercial solar and storage stuff, and some very interesting little finds. But I don't know where I'm going right now, so I'll be back once I've found something to look at.
So I was doing a bit to camera about Eton, and then this SpongeBob creature has come up behind me. No, not going to wave. Hello. So you might have seen Eton in one of my other videos, because I've got a DC UPS that I use to keep my router running. That's a really useful little gadget for when there's power cuts or you're working on power in the house. But they also make a lot of commercial UPSs for data centers. And what I didn't realize is that they are now making EV chargers. So there's a 44 kilowatt DC EV charger and a 22 kilowatt one there just behind me. So it's good to see that they're branching out into all sorts of different products now. A company here called Offstar, and they make a lot of smart products and also solar inverters and battery systems and related components like that. So I've had a chat with someone on the stand. It turns out Toyo are a major investor in this company, and all of their products, their inverters and things, they all integrate with the Toyo Smart Life platform. And I think that's a really unique proposition. I mean, they've got a big boost already. If you can buy a solar inverter or an EV charger, and you know that it's going to work with your home automation system because it's a Toyo product. I mean, was that something like 500 million IoT devices running Toyo platform on the internet? So it's quite a big thing. And for them to be investing in home energy solutions and crossing that with smart products, then it's quite a big deal, I think. If you're in the market for an EV charger, then you really are spoilt for choice now, because there's flipping hundreds here. They're just literally, every manufacturer seems to have got their own EV charger now. So the market for that is really saturated. So I think if there's one thing I can take away from this day, it's that if you're looking for battery storage, you really are spoilt for choice. I think the market is starting to get quite saturated, so the companies are all looking for different ways to differentiate themselves. A lot of them are using the term all-in-one now, but that means something different for each company. A lot of the products, they're basically all the same specs. You've got the same sort of power output, the same sort of modular capacity, so you can add or increase in like 5 kilowatt hour chunks. They've all got smart controls, although, you know, differentiation there is that some of them are proprietary, some of them are open, some of them are UK only, like Give Energy are promoting, and some of them are very Chinese centric, like Toyo, which is quite an international company. So, you know, you've really got a lot to choose from. So I don't know how to sum this video up really, but you know, go and have a look, get yourself to one of these shows, and have a look around at the products and see which one takes your fancy. Just got back to my car, and it looks like another electric Corsa has found the only other electric Corsa in the car park and parked next to it. Hey, twinsies.